Anil Rajdhan Saab, former Secretary Power, Government of India, Mr. Walter Howard, Mr. Peter Novak, Director, Institute of High Technologies, Mr. Martin Keller, Director, NREL, Itsuyuku Ekiba, Professor, International Research Center for Hydrogen Energy, Japan, Mr. Rajendra Kora, Dr. Anil Garg, and other dignitaries sitting in the audience, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It is indeed a great pleasure and privilege for me to welcome each one of you to the valedictory session of 8th World Renewable Energy Technology Congress. In the inaugural address, Honorable Minister has spoken about the decarbonization, decentralization, and digitization of energy space, without which there would be deceleration of global economy. We understand the energy intensity is reducing the world over as we are becoming more energy efficient. However, the GDP of any country is closely linked to the total energy consumption, and as the GDP of developing economies shall increase at higher rate, these economies would demand increase in energy over time, and there would be a disproportionate increase in energy consumption in developing economies, and therefore there is a greater need for more responsible consumption and generation in these economies. The sustainable development goals Shri Anil Rajdhan Ji talked about in the opening session are much more relevant for developing economies. He had especially talked about Goal 7, affordable and clean energy, and he further talked about targets which stipulate increase in access to energy, energy services, increase in share of renewable energy in the global energy mix, double the global rate improvement in energy efficiency, enhance international cooperation to facilitate access to clean energy, research and technology, including RE, by 2030. The conference had witnessed focused discussion on various issues on global cooperation for sustainability, RE commitments in COP21, green banking for sustainability, energy storage, e-vehicles, smart cities, advances in bioenergy, skill development, manufacturing, etc. The conference has provided an opportunity to explore various dimensions of stimulating technology, trade and development in the renewable energy sector. It also sets a platform for deliberations on strategies and activities for mutual cooperation towards energy security in our countries. Given the multifold challenges, technological, financial, political, and environmental, no one organization or country can tackle them alone, and therefore there is a greater need for global cooperation in meeting our sustainable goals. I sincerely thank all the participants for the views, suggestions, and recommendations toward global cooperation for sustainability and meeting commitments to sustainable acceleration of RE in the energy mix. Shri Rajendra Kora, CMD of Virgin Group, shall be presenting the declaration of 8th World Renewable Energy Technology Congress during this session. I am sure each one of you would be carrying a message for sustainability in your respective fields of work. With these words, I would like to thank the organizers for inviting me and giving me this opportunity to welcome you to this valedictory session. Thank you. Thank you very much.